2, 2.
One counter, one clock, one pair of tap shoes. What we have to do is to get a million onto this counter as soon as possible. We'll start with one. Now that's on this end. All we have to do is to get that one on the other end, and we're away. Start the music, lads.
1, 2, come on, 2, 3.
Are you wise?
And that's Roy Castle off. He's on tap. For 1 million taps, we're talking about an incredible marathon over about 24 hours. He's doing it all for charity, and if anyone can do it, Roy Castle can do it, and we all wish him the very best of luck.
Two men here crucial to the record-breaking attempt, the medical team, Dr. Bill.
He's going to come in every 20 minutes for 4 or 5 minutes, or even longer if we think it's necessary, and during that time, I shall be checking his physical condition, and my friend here will be seeing to his feet and his legs and his general muscular problems.
So Terry, you're the osteopath, you'll be limbering Roy up. What is your role exactly?
Well, I shall be mainly trying to relax the muscles where they get tight as he's using for such a long period of time.
That's 50,000 taps in 59 minutes. It's fantastic. If he keeps going at this rate, he's well on course for his million taps.
Roy was off to a flying start, but already some younger members of the audience were feeling the pace.
Yeah!
100,000 on the counter, 2 hours on the clock. With Roy well on schedule, he marked this first milestone with a change of t-shirt and a celebratory fanfare.
You let yourself go nice and easy.
Yes, yes. Get the jigsaw back into place now.
Get your nice and loose and mobile for yeah. That's the last time for 24 hours.
Okay.
Well, I wish I could fade all the faders and do a bit of tap dancing at the same time, because I join in with Roy Castle as he taps for a million. Do I hear the taps? Yes, I do.
How are you doing, Gloria? All right, you sitting down?
Yes, I am.
Oh, you're the lucky one.
Listen, how do you feel at the moment?
Well, I'm feeling very good. I'm quite surprised. I'm scared to say anything, but we've done 211,000 now, so I've done more than a fifth of it in about 4 hours.
How did you train for this, Roy?
I've done a lot of running just to get the stamina going so that I won't pack it in. And then I've been eating the right sort of foods, a lot of raw food. And then a few days before, I've done the usual pasta eating. I've eaten pasta until it sent me deaf. It's coming out of my ears, you know. And then on the morning, this morning, I had a steak and 2 eggs.
Of course, an awful lot of people will say, why does this man do it? He must be mad.
Straight away, they're right. It's cuckoo land, but then again, without people trying for our charities, as you know, they might get left behind a little bit, and we don't want that to happen, do we?
Did anybody ever try this before?
No, this is the first go, so I'm setting up a challenge to the rest of the tap dancers in the world. As long as they do it for charity, it's okay.
Well, Roy, I think it's a marvellous effort, I really do. What kind of music have you chosen to keep you going the 24 hours?
Well, I've done my own. I've got a little 8-track recording thing, and I've done my own music.
And who's doing all the counting?
We've got an electronical digital counter built by the BBC, of course.
I had this awful mental picture, you know, of some poor soul trying to count to a million.
Brian Hunt, I know everyone's just dying to know how Roy's taps are being measured. Tell me, how does it all work?
Right. Well, Roy is creating
particular sounds by beating his metal-tipped shoes against marble flooring. These sounds we are picking up on a number of sensors and taking them to a specially designed counting system. We then do some filtering on that to remove any extraneous noises, and we present it in a counting system for the public.
$300,000 up. Roy was over a quarter of the way. If he could carry on at this rate, he was well on course to complete his marathon attempt within 24 hours and still have time for a regular change of t-shirt, this time assisted by wife Fiona.
Yeah, yeah! I'm enjoying it. I really do think I'm going to do it.
I'm worn out looking at you.
With the evening drawing on, Kathy Starr, known to millions as Nora Batty in Last of the Summer Wine, was the first of many celebrities to come along and lend her support.
Feeling okay. Feet are all right. Probably be a bit stiff.
Yeah, no sweat.
At the end of it all.
That's good. Right, just let them stay up there for a while.
Okay.
We'll just give you a while and just let them dry.
Set the socks up. I'm going to change.
Yeah, you keep your feet up. I'll take your socks
off. See, they're all right, aren't they?
Yeah, they're tremendous. It's got no sweat in there at all. A bit warm though now, those socks.
Think of all the adverts I can do for batteries.
Yes, that's what you remind me of, one of those little bunnies.
Yes, he's one of those little dolls. Yeah, listen, if you've got any more like you, I could sell you down at the corner down the market on Monday. Yeah, don't worry, we can get a box of them, we could do a deal, me and you.
Do you think Roy's going to make it?
He's bound to make it. He's got enough support here, and I think he looks very fit.
He's incredibly fit.
Imagine he won't be tomorrow morning.
Seven!
Midnight, and I don't know about Roy, but I'm exhausted. Now, should he be feeling as good as he obviously is right now?
Well, not really, no. I mean, he's putting us both to shame, because he's bright, he's alert, and he's in amazing condition for the effort he's put in so far.
Defying medical science.
Well, he's certainly not necessarily defying it, but he's stretching it to its outer limits.
Coming up to it.
Here we go.
Right, well, see if we can get these muscles loosened up a bit there.
No.
Bit of fatigue sign there, no?
Oh, boy. Tap, 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 tap. Thank goodness it stopped for a bit. What's that?
That was a group of students from Roy's own tap dance school. With the counter switched off, they treated the audience to one of their own routines.
Hey, Roy, you've made the morning paper.
What?
There we are.
Oh. Hey, that's a long time ago, isn't it?
I know, you've got to keep going.
With dawn breaking over Piccadilly, Roy had tapped his way through the night. With the start of his attempt featured in a number of the morning papers, the end was now in sight.
Well, let's go for the evening one.
Right, here we go.
Here we go again.
Many of the audience had been there for the whole 19 hours and were beginning to feel the pace. Even Dr. Bill couldn't resist a quick snooze.
Oh, this is nice, isn't it? Wow!
The 900,000 in the big one!
I should spring back into life now for this last bit.
That's not bad at all, actually.
All right, they've lasted out, okay.
Oh, they've lasted out fantastically.
That ice is doing it a lot of good, isn't it? Yeah. Pulse is okay?
Yes, the pulse is fine.
Magic figure of 1 million approaching, it was time for a change of tune. Roy's final choice of music was written by his youngest son, Benjamin. An expectant crowd looked on as the counter spun through the last 100 digits. It looked as if Roy's months of training and preparation were going to pay off.
Nine, jump!
1 million taps. In 23 hours and 44 minutes, Roy had tapped his way to a new world record and raised thousands of pounds for charity in the process.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a wonderful feeling, I'm happier. That was a song and dance routine made famous by the great dancer Gene Kelly in the film of the same name. Doris and Ross, are there any records on tap dancing?
Well, no, not really. The nearest we've heard of is a heel stomping record in flamenco dancing. It was set in September 1967 in Australia by a man called Valero de Jerez.
Yeah.
And he measured at 16 taps a second, which is a rate of 960 a minute.
16 a second, well, how do you count them?
Well, you can count it on a machine like this. Is a digital counter, and it's attached to a gun microphone, which I'll hand gingerly to Ross, and that'll show how many taps you can do in a second.
Yeah?
So, do you want to try?
Oh, well, I'd like to have a try, just to see, you know.
Well?
The step I'm going to do is, you put that foot down,
yeah.
That's one,
yeah.
Then you do two on this foot,
yeah.
Then, in dragging that foot back and putting this foot down, you catch on that one there.
Okay, so that's five, then, in each...
Well, it's five altogether, because
yes.
Then the heel of this is just starting another five. So every time I change feet, it should be 5 feet.
Well, we'll see what the digital counter says.
All right. Digital counter. Yeah. Right, here we go now. I'll start slowly and
we'll
work up to some kind of a pace.
Right, we'll dance away, then.
Right,
and we'll watch.
Go. 17, he's done 17 there in that second. And that's faster than the 16. A fantastic performance. He's up back to 12, 9, up to 11, 16 again. That equaled the world record. And 17 is faster. 18, 22, 23, 24. That's fantastic. Into 24. That's enough.
You shattered it. Well, that was 24, which is 1,440 taps in a minute.
So hey,
you are a record breaker.
In the heart of little old New York, you'll find a thoroughfare. It's the part of little old New York that runs into Times Square. A crazy quilt that Wall Street Jack built. If you've got a little time to spare, I wanna take you there. Let's meet where dancing feet are on the avenue. I'm taking you to 42nd Street. Hear the beat of dancing feet. Oops, song, I love the melody of 42nd Street. With tapping feet, it's the biggest dance troupe in the whole world, waiting for the thank you.
part of the biggest tap dancing troupe in the whole world?
Yes, I am.
What's your name?
Julie.
Ah. Why did you form the biggest tap dancing troupe in the whole world?
For charity.
Charity?
Yes.
Which one?
The Action Research for the Crippled Child.
Yeah?
Yes.
And are you doing well?
Yes, we are.
I'd like to wish you a lot of luck with it.
Thank you very much.
Well done. Pardon me asking, but where are the other 499?
Right here.
Just in case we have to do a little swimming?
I hope not.
Just in case you're wondering,
Here's how 36 world record breakers with every reason to be on a bit of a high came down to earth with a bit of a bang. Now, I've never parascended ever before, so I don't know anything about it. Now, you're going to have to tell me what are the safety bits on
you. All right. The main thing I need you to do, Roy, is to actually steer the canopy while I'll be towing you under the bridges. That is your rear riser. That will steer you right. Okay?
So if I pull on this,
you pull on that, that will
right.
Turn the canopy to the right.
Okay.
This is the left side. Roy?
Yeah.
We'll just clip you into there.
We'll steer you left.
Left.
Right.
Okay. So as we approach the bridges, all I want you to do is stay right behind the powerboat. Okay, away you go, Roy. Woo! What Dave's going to try and do is to give him a circuit so he takes him down towards the bridge and he'll turn the boat around again and then start coming back towards us. Nice little gust of wind there, lifting him. The chute should stay nice and steady normally. Nice and steady. Getting blown around a little bit, old Roy up there. Very brave man, very good. He's now bringing him down nice and low the water now. Skimming him through the water. This is the best method of getting him under the bridge because by putting the guide's feet into the water, it helps us to keep the canopy down low when we're ascending underneath the bridges. But I think Roy's really enjoying this. Not ideal conditions out there. It's blowing a bit and the chute's getting thrown around all over the sky. But at least it's giving Roy a feeling and it gives him a chance to know what's going on the day.
Ah, hey, that was great. I felt really good there. Yeah,
really great.
It's a bit heavy on the hands, isn't it? It's a bit sharp on the fingers.
We'll give you a pair of gloves on the day.
Yeah, all right.
Really
I loved it. It was really good.
Marvelous. This mud's
yeah.
If the wind is blowing this direction, okay, we'll be using this takeoff point. If the wind's blowing up the river, we'll be using this takeoff point here.
Come straight round.
Then we come straight round and down here. Okay, we go to Lambeth, then through Westminster. This is the worst one. This is the lowest one.
Oh,
34.3,
yeah.
Yeah.
I'll be in the water there.
That's right. This one's quite a high one, Charing Cross. Once we come to Charing Cross, then we come down to Waterloo. This is a very high bridge. That one you should clear easily.
Yes.
This one here is just like a tunnel. Okay, you've got two of them together. Mm. Okay, very, very close.
So you have trouble with the wind there?
Yeah, if anything, we'll get trouble here with the wind. You won't be able to come up at all, so you'll stay down low for both of them.
Yeah.
Through there, through to Suffolk.
Yeah.
And once you get to Cannon Street, you're on the Homewood Strait.
Well, will you?
Okay. Then once you get to London Bridge, you can then see Tower Bridge in the foreground. And then once you come here, under Tower Bridge, on the parachute, you're clear.
So that's when the clock stops, once the parachute's through.
Yeah, as soon as the parachute is through, we've done it.
And we hope it's 44 something.
Oh, better if we can.
Yeah?
Better.
Don't be too confident. It's the conditions, isn't it?
Yeah, weather.
Let's
very
hope
much.
That we have some good conditions.
Ah, well, Roy, the weather looks pretty good.
It's all right for you, is it?
Yeah, it's
quite nice, isn't it, if it holds.
Yeah. Coming through?
What about the wind?
Just nice. Light wind.
Yeah.
Just nice. Coming straight down the river.
Yeah.
Should be nice.
And which takeoff point do you prefer now?
I want to use the far point, which is up there by Vauxhall Bridge.
Okay.
Okay, so we use takeoff point two. From there, up, bring you along here, nice and low.
Yeah.
For that first difficult one.
Morning, Maggie. good luck on this one. Splendid so far.
Woo-hoo! Da-da-da! Lovely, this is fantastic.
Put up there then, Roy. Roy must be having a splendid time up there. It looks fabulous, London, along the river.
How's the time, Julian?
Going fine. We've done about 6 minutes, Roy.
Start descending in now. Get him nice and low. He's absolutely spot on behind the powerboat. Really great. Good bit of flying from Roy there.
I can't drift him through this one. It's a nice bridge, this one.
He's drifting through this one. Charing Cross Bridge.
Okay, he's now coming under the bridge. Marvellous, he's clearing it beautifully. Okay, great. A little bit of power now, and he's clear.
Ta-da, ta-da, the other one through. Woo-hoo! Top one coming up now. It's going to be a juggle, this. Oh, it's marvellous from up here. No traffic jams.
We're going really well.
The other way. Quick time to do a lap of honour. Whee!
This is the hardest bridge now. This is Blackfriars, a Blackfriars railway bridge. Very hard indeed. The most difficult bridge of the lot. I'm getting a lot of wake off these boats. I can't bring him up. He's got to stay down low all the time. But we can clear. There we go. We're through. Absolutely magic.
Da-da-da-da. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Great. How about that, eh? Wonderful.
8 minutes now, Brian, and we're about halfway.
The second one's Cannon Street Railway Bridge, and we've got a wind direction change at the moment, which is making it very difficult to drive. It's always dropping up and down.
Old record.
Should have got time for a lap of honour.
What? You got the final time now, did you?
No, what was it?
15 minutes 57.
15:57. Whoa!
Just to the east of Paris, everything's set for Roy's arrival. The weather's brilliant, and so long as he gets here in one piece, he should have a perfect landing. She's over the channel by now, and they've planned the crossing at its narrowest point between Dover and Cap Blanc Nez.
It's getting pretty cold up here now. Never mind, it's just as well I've got my own thermals. Thumbs up, keep going.
We're here in Blackpool to set a record by taking a quick route from the top of the tower over there to the pond below by rope slide. But the good thing is that we've got the Royal Marines here to set it all up.
It's 8 a.m. and way down there people are starting a normal day in Blackpool. Up here we're preparing for something that might even turn the knees of a marine to jelly. The last time this was done was from the top of the LWT building in London. But at 400 feet up, this is altogether higher, further and faster than anything that's ever been attempted before. What a way to celebrate our birthday.
The whole town's come to a standstill and they're having to stop the trams because they're cutting the power off. And it's time I got going because what you don't know is we're doing it too.
Alan Heward, you're the Marine that set all this up. It looks like it's going to be a long way down there and you're first over the edge. So what kind of speed are we going to be doing?
Well, I estimate that we'll be going somewhere between about 25, 35 mile an hour.
Yeah?
At the peak.
And at the bottom, how are we going to stop?
At the bottom, there's a brake man, and as you can see, there's the big yellow airbag. If the brake man doesn't stop you, I'm sure the airbag will.
Oh, it's high, isn't it?
Right, what I'll do then is I'll introduce you to my colleague here, Tony Boyle. He's going to be the guy who's responsible for dispatching you. Or another way of putting it, the guy who's going to throw you off.
Any final questions before we go?
Yes, can I go home now, please?
No. We'll sit you on the edge, and when you sit on the edge, you'll be all secured up. Nice safety harness on there. I'll give you a countdown, 3, 2, 1, and then we'll go off the edge. Before you know it, 20, 30 seconds time, be down on the ground and be a record breaker.
Got it?
Yeah.
Pull this straight up. Right onto there and over your shoulder. And you can move it down.
Yeah, that's it. That's the other part.
Pull them down there.
Comfy?
I've been comfier.
You're there. Yeah. Do I look confident?
You look good. You're looking good. Feeling fine.
Okay, we're ready then. Can we have the power off now, please?
Roger.
Your arms have got to be straight all the way down.
Right.
And if for any apparent reason you want to let go, you let go. You're on a safety stroke.
All of that, darling.
Okay, stand by, toggle over, go on.
We don't need to do it now, do we?
Done now.
It's been done.
Okay, stand by, Roy Castle. Toggle over. Go.
Right.
Straight up. Straight up. Straighten your arm.
Good one. Oh, I do like to be. Oh, I do like to be.
Breakfast now.
Factory
shuttle
base.
1, 2, 3, go.
Straight up! Straight up!
Legs together, good one!
edge of a river. Oh, it looks so nice. Can you see the ground?
Congratulations.
I know.
Roy, I can't believe we slid down there on a rope. Can you?
I know.
Was there a time when you didn't think you'd be able to do it?
Well, last night, I was trying to imagine it. You know, I'd never seen the rope. I didn't know what it was going to be like. I know I'd been up to the top of the tower and when I was a kid, and I thought then, wow, that's a long way down, looking on top of seagulls. And I really wasn't sure whether I'd bottle out or not. But I'm glad I've done it.
It's the most brilliant thing I've ever done. Mm. How about you? Has anything better than this?
Well, I've done a parachute jump and I've done parascending under the London bridges, but there was nothing that had a bigger tingle than sitting on the edge there, waiting to go off.
Could you do it again?
Yeah.
Two, one. Off you go, Tom.
Well, that was fairly painless. Simone Hines and Samantha Lewis from Grange Hill, bringing the grand total to 369.
Yeah, that's France all right. I can smell the garlic. Oh well, there's quite a bit to go yet. The legs are aching now. Come on, Brendan, stick the toe down. Let's get there. Oh, it'll be nice to see Paris. Hey, look who we've got here. Where have you been? I hear you've had a bit of trouble, lad. Nice to know you're okay. You can't actually go near the Eiffel Tower. We haven't got regulations. Yeah, I don't mind all that. I hope he's telling them that we're near the runway, that's all. I'd love to see him now. I've just about had it.
Numbers will grow until we reach that record.
Back in the back of the day.